Okay, Randy, we have your transmission out and disassembled on the bench here. I'm going to have my master builder, Carl, walk you through and show you what we found.
These clutches here are for third gear. Here's a steel and the clutch. Steel and a clutch, and you see they're metal on metal. Here's another one, metal on metal. And it got so hot when it was slipping that this spring is misshaped and sticking out. That's going to have to be replaced. And this retainer right here where it's been misshaped and rubbing, that's also going to have to be replaced. Here's for second gear. And you see there's a lot more clutch material left, but the steel's been hot. They've been slipping also. So all the steels and all the clutches are going to have to be replaced. Here's a sprag, it's like a one-way clutch. It's got a big groove right here in the gear itself, and that's going to have to be replaced. And here's the sprag element that it rides on, and that's also worn and going to have to be replaced. It's been so hot, it's turned purple. Something in there's failed, and that's gonna have to be replaced.
Okay, so what this is gonna take is a full rebuild with some parts. Also, there's this filter, there's two filters on this, an external and an internal. This internal filter will have to be replaced while we're there too. It's just got a real super tiny hole that picks up this fluid, and you can't probably see inside there. That paper filter element's just collapsed. And also the torque converter. I will have this written up as a PDF and attached to this. The cooler system will need to be flushed thoroughly. I will show you that in the next segment. Review all this information and get back to me and let me know what you want to do. Thanks, Randy.
Okay, this is our hot flush machine, and it's not hooked up to your car, but it's going to be, and this is just an example to show you how it works. As you can see on the side here, the hot flush is hooked up to shop air pressure. That runs over there to the lift. And then these hoses are hooked to the vehicle. And what happens is this runs heated transmission fluid through the transmission cooler system in the vehicle. And what it does is this heated fluid gets up to about 190 degrees. Right now it's only at about 179 degrees. But it'll get up to 190, and we usually set the timer for 3 hours. This one is currently set for 1 hour. We'll bump this up. But 3 hours is a normal time that we run it. And it runs heated fluid for 3 seconds, and then for half a second, it blasts 150 pounds of shop air the opposite way. And that's the pulsation that you see and hear. And right now, this one, it'll get up to about 60 pounds. Right now, it's running about 20 pounds, but it'll get up here to 50 or 60 pounds. And then it also measures volume here. Right now, this is flowing about 5 gallons a minute is what that's flowing. I don't know if you see that with the glare on it or not. But see if I get a better shot of that. Where that orange line is, that's right at 5 gallons a minute. And it's heated fluid, and it gets all that metal and clutch debris out. And this is a state-of-the-art machine. I mean, it just doesn't get any better than that. That's the hot flush machine, and that's what's going to be hooked up to your car to get all that contamination out of the cooler.